Okay, on behalf of the Academy, I extend warm welcome to all the participants. Today, we have a session on workshop accounts. To take up the session, we have Sri P.V. Raghav Rao. He's retired as senior AFA in South Central Railway and presently working as faculty IRIFAM. It's over to you, sir, to come on the session.
Thank you, Benhar. I welcome you all to this afternoon session. We will be introducing you these workshop accounts from Sitara side, from our accounts faculty. We will have four sessions, four sessions, and we will be having a part-wise items, and at the end we will have MCQs also. So what I will do, first I will run the slides and also explain the workshop accounts from the preliminary point, from the basics. From there onwards, I will be asking you the questions for interactions. Am I audible to all of you? Please, anyone of you, please respond. Samantha ji?
You're audible, sir.
May I get a response from one of the participants?
We all are muted.
Okay. It's okay.
Okay.
Thank you, Benhar. So good afternoon, all of you. I welcome you to this session. Today, we will be looking into the various aspects of the workshop management, wherein which we have a major function incurring the revenue expenditure on the general railway. Normally, if you see the overall structure of railway working, we have general railways. Under the general railway working, we do have workshops for maintenance of various assets, that is including the rolling stock. Normally, these rolling stock consisting of locos, carriages, and wagons. And the responsibility of the maintenance of these rolling stock assets of this rolling stock is rested with the one of the HODs, that is principal chief mechanical engineer. He is the head of the mechanical department, and he will be the in charge for maintenance of this asset. When we say maintenance of this asset, normally the procurement as well as replacement of these assets over time are also rest with this management in a general railway. So it is the duty of the principal chief mechanical engineer to ensure the rolling stock that is kept at the general railways for this business of transportation is maintained in good condition, and at the end he should ensure the safety and reliability of the transportation facilities made to the passengers and as well as the other customers who are carrying the commodities. So as such, the department exercises control over the workshops. I mean, there may be some in a general railway, there may be one or two workshops, there may be loco workshop, a carriage workshop, a wagon workshop, a carriage workshop, maybe one or two, maybe wagon workshop, maybe one or two, and along with the depots, online maintenance depots and coaching depots and the sheds that are there for the regular online maintenance. These general railway workshops will carry out the periodical maintenance of these assets. Normally, when we say the maintenance, it is a preventive maintenance. What is this preventive maintenance? What is this preventive maintenance? What consists of? What happens to if we don't maintain our asset in a systematic way? Normally, if you want to have a corrective maintenance means we will be maintaining the assets, running the assets non-stop, and only when there is a breakdown. So that means the reliability of the asset is on the high side. The reliability of the asset is on the high side. If you see the population of rolling stock of Indian Railways, the size of the rolling stock, the population, is about, we do have around 12,500 locos, which consists of electric locos and as well as the diesel locos. And we have about 92,000 of various passenger carrying vehicles, these various coaches we call them. And then we do have about 2.9 lakh freight cars, that is wagons. This is the size of our population. The size of the population is the approximate size I have mentioned. But it is the responsibility of these to maintain the railway, to maintain these assets in a manner, in such a manner that we have to ensure our transportation needs are continuous and are available always and are available always available to the Indian economy. So if we have the corrective maintenance practice, that means when the asset is maintained only at the time of breakdown, that is one idea. That means availability of the asset is always there, means it gives more earning. And if you have preventive maintenance, that means withdrawing these assets from the traffic and maintain them for some period. That means we have for the holding of these assets in a workshop for a particular period. It means this preventive maintenance practice of our assets, what happens, thereby we have to have this number of population available for the service in addition. Means, however it is necessary. That means we are ensuring the fitness of these assets so that they continuously serve up to their quota life. This means we have to have a balancing act of having the corrective maintenance and preventive maintenance. As such, we'll be incurring the expenditure on maintaining these assets both online and as well as the offline, that is in general railway workshops, in such a way that these assets are maintained thoroughly and in a good and fit manner. As such, they are available for the service continuously. That means various practices we do in our workshops. That is, today we are using the unit exchange spare mechanism, and thereby the level of availability of the rolling stock, and that means with this we will be having higher levels of the availability of rolling stock for the system working. That is the importance of the workshop maintenance. So let us look at who does what for this purpose, for having so much responsibility. Who does what kind of work and what is happening for having, for prescribing the specifications, designs for the various types of locos and rolling carriages and wagons, and also having the choosing the most economical option on the life cycle basis. The rest with the responsibility of in this kind of activity is rest with the RDSO basically RDSO and the railway board enables authorization. That is the of rolling stock, the responsibility of manufacturing the rolling stock, the rest with the production units, and however some of the general railway workshops also and some external manufacturers also do this work. This is when I say manufacturing and assembling of the rolling stock, it is an expenditure of capital intensive nature. That means we will be procuring and also replacing these rolling stock under the rolling stock program. Is it investment program? That is like an investment planning. We can call it as an investment planning. The responsibility of the manufacturing or assembly of these major important asset rests with the production units and also some of the general railway workshops and also some external manufacturer wherever possible. Then periodical major overhauls and midlife rehabilitation of these rolling stock is the responsibility of the general railway workshops, and then midlife rehabilitation workshops prescribed for this purpose. There are some workshops on the MLR workshops. And then if you see in the Bhopal, there is a midlife rehabilitation workshop. Here, when I say the capital expenditure for manufacture goes to investment program under demand number 16, SRI demand number 16, and the periodical maintenance is a revenue expenditure under respective demands 5, 6, demand 5 and 6 basically, repairs and maintenance of erstwhile demands. Today it is under various other sub-major heads. The demand number 5 is repairs and maintenance of locomotives, and demand number 6 goes to repairs and maintenance of carriages and wagons. That is the major important demands for incurring the revenue expenditure on account of periodical overhauling. This is dealt on the general railway workshops. Similarly, there are top overhauls and minor schedules in IOH, we call it as intermediate overhauling, and other routine overhauls of various schedules is dealt at the loco sheds and also carriage and wagon depots, which is a revenue expenditure, which is a revenue expenditure. This revenue expenditure is dealt by the divisions. The revenue expenditure for POH is dealt by the workshops, and carrying, cleaning, topping and supplies of various components to regular maintenance, online maintenance also dealt by the divisions under the divisional management. That is, if you see, senior divisional mechanical engineer is responsible for main online maintenance of carriages and wagons. And periodical overhauling expenditure related to the carriages is with the zonal railway workshop management. And the online maintenance related to supplies and all other things for the sheds, locomotives is rest with the divisional management purview. So that is how expenditure related to the maintenance, online maintenance, as well as the preventive breakdown maintenance has a bifurcation, wherein which we will be funding these activities. Funding the activities is an important concern, wherein which we will be incurring the expenditure in a major way, thereby we will be have to have a proper control over expenditure mechanism. We have to have a proper control or mechanism for which we have the various methods and systems and procedures for dealing with the control over expenditure mechanism. That is about the, that is related to the activities and functions of the main procurement, replacement of rolling stock, as well as the maintaining the rolling stock on account of preventive maintenance, and as well as the running maintenance. That is how deal with the workshop activities and functions. This is, please, all of you, please look at these activities and functions and the classification of expenditure related to the expenditure on account of revenue and also the procurement and replacement of the rolling stock. That is how the responsibilities are rest and laid. Then let us just go into the workshop now physically. There is a, I just taken a small workshop layout, a small workshop layout. There is an in-gate and there is an out-gate. When I say workshop, it is under the General Railway Administration. It is a General Railway workshop, and the assets, that is the wagons. Here in this case, you are seeing a diagram of the wagon repair workshop, where which there is an in-gate and there is an out-gate. When such an important asset is getting repaired under a periodical overhauling, then normally activities under this kind of maintenance, preventive maintenance, consist of 2-3 major activities. One is a periodical overhauling, we call it as POH. Then is another activity is known as corrosion repairs. There is another activity, and more activity is known as special repairs. Normally corrosion repair activity deals with the corrosive part of the items. The periodical overhauling deals with the periodical scheduling, where in according to maintain its total life of an asset, you'll be replacing some of the components in such a way that the asset is maintained in a good condition for the entire its life and as well as during the service. That is, so that means a periodical overhauling means some kind of periodicity is there, some kind of a periodicities. Normally, for a wagon, so many years, 2.5 years. And for a coach, where the passenger cat travels, it is 18 months plus or minus 6 months. So like that, we will have some kind of a periodicity. So from in-gate to out-gate, we will be holding this asset. Thereby, during this period, this asset is not earning to railways. This asset is not able to earn to the railways. As such, it is important that we have to send this asset out of this service very quickly. That means the holding time of this asset should be as minimum as possible in such a way that the asset should be available. The asset should be available for earning for earnings. In case of wagons, it should earn loading. No? By way of loading, you will be getting the earnings. Maybe coal, loading wagons, iron ore, various food grains, cement. So we carry these important commodities. Importantly, for these commodities, we need to have these assets in good conditions as well. Availability of these wagons to the system for our transportation needs. So from in-gate to out-gate, if you see, I will show you the small things. For example, if we, so normally from in-gate to out-gate, it goes to an average holding time. Normally when it comes to shop-wise, so it goes to shop-wise. So it goes to body shop and then it goes to wheel. Wheel shop will be, wheels are taken out. Bogie shop, bogie is taken out and wheels are done. And like this, they all go to paint shop at the end and it goes out of the workshop. That means here if you see various shops are there. There is a shop and then entire activities is done as a workshop. As such, the activities, just look at this layout. An activity is of a stripping shop, activities of a body shop, activities of a wheel shop. So there may be activities. So for maintaining this activity, there will be POH, there may be corrosion repair, there may be a special repair, there may be in a some other kind of a workshop like locos and garage, there may be some kind of manufacturing of a component may be involved. So many things, so many activities may be there. Broadly, these are the activities related to service or periodical overhauling, corrosion repairs, and special repairs. These are the basic service activities dealt in a general railway for workshops for the maintenance purpose of the rolling stock. So, but however, here the expenditure, here we are involved, we are concerned with the expenditure related to the workshop. So, workshop expenditure normally. The direct expenditure related to activities, the indirect expenditure related to the activities. So here we can observe from this entire workshop area, if you see the indirect expenditure and direct expenditure related to activities. So direct expenditure related to direct activities and indirect expenditure. For example, an indirect expenditure incurred. Indirect expenditure incurred in various activities in a shop, indirect expenditure incurred for various activities in a shop is known as shop on cost. Again, I will explain in detail in the on cost class. And indirect expenditure incurred in common to all shops, all incurred in common to all shops, general on cost. So shop on cost or general on cost, that is known as works on cost. That is how we see this as expenditure. So expenditure related to work collected through the work orders is identified as direct expenditure and indirect expenditure. Indirect expenditure is treated as on cost, and these on costs are shop on cost, general on cost, and there is another cost as a performer. I will explain in detail in the future. Now we will go further into the administrative aspect of the workshop responsibilities. The objectives of the zonal railway workshops are normally, again, we have discussed this. undertakes repairs and maintenance of various kinds of rolling stock on periodical maintenance, and again manufacture of components or spare parts. Components or spare parts are the same, or duplicates are the same. These are the part of that. And building activities of rolling stock such as coach and wagon building. So this is another part of the activity. So this company, we will be doing some kind of modification works. We will be doing some kind of major activity work. This means when I maintain the asset, it is known as revenue expenditure. When I procure an asset, it is a capital expenditure. When I do some kind of restructuring of an asset, is known as also a capital expenditure. It is a capital intensive expenditure. So building activities of rolling stock such as coach wagon building is a capital expenditure. Undertake repair and works related to rolling stock owned by other bodies. For example, in Indian railway system, we also carry other entities rolling stock, such as, for example, we have NTPC is there, National Thermal Power Corporation. They own their wagons. Their wagons have to be run on our system, or maybe some alumina company, maybe some iron and steel companies. They may be owning their wagons, but those wagons have to be run on our system. So when they're running on our system, normally those assets have to be maintained by us only for the purpose of safety considerations, because we are responsible for the safety of the track. As such, we will be taking those works. When we take up the other works, it is known as a deposit work. When we take up a work pertaining to the other than the railways, we will take up those work based on the deposit work terms and conditions, deposit, because we collect money from them based on the estimate, and that based on that estimate, they have to give the money in advance, based on which we will be taking up the work in our workshops. Similarly, we also take up some of the works related to divisions. Whenever the online maintenance that is happening in the division, they may requisition some of the services from the general daily works. As such, those items are also taken as an activity. So basically, these are all the important activities of a workshop. These are the most important activities. These five are the important activities of a journal railway workshop. And this is the objective of the journal railway workshop, to do the job. So let us look at the functional authorities of a journal railway workshop. Because unless until these functional authorities are available, we cannot fund them, we cannot plan, and we cannot deliver our services. So as such, let us discuss about them in brief. So here the most important person is principal chief mechanical engineer, who is in charge of the rolling stock in a journal railways. So principal chief mechanical engineer has to be assisted by some of the HODs. So first important HOD is chief workshop engineer. He is having direct control on the affairs of the all workshops available within his journal library, within the journal library. So he is the chief workshop engineer. His responsibility is to fund the activities. That means when we are say funding the activities of anything, funding the activity means nothing but providing the budget grant for that particular year, because you are all aware that budget has to be sanctioned by the president and voted by the parliament. Unless until that is happened, any authority cannot incur any expenditure related to the public money. As such, he is the responsibility, chief workshop engineer is the responsible officer to fund the activities within his purview. He is the budgetary control, he is having the budgetary control of all activities in the workshop, both for the revenue expenditure and also with the expenditure related to the providing assistance to the planning officer. Similarly, there is another authority known as Chief Motive Power Engineer. He is responsible for the technical maintenance of diesel locos. Slowly and slowly, today we were discussing how many diesel locos are there. About 12,500 locos are there. Diesel locomotives are there. Of 12,500 locos, we have only about 5,500, around 5,500 only diesel locos are there. Now slowly and slowly, we are withdrawing the entire diesel loco traction and replacing them with the electric traction. We are withdrawing the diesel loco traction and replacing with the electric traction. As such, slowly and slowly, the diesel locos and the fuel maintenance and fuel things, they are slowly and slowly fading out. But however, as on date, we have to have this responsibility, and Chief Motive Power Engineer is the technical, he exercises technical control over the diesel locomotives for the in the locomotive sheds, shops, and ensure their performance on the online, and then midlife rehabilitation, POH, supplies of various items related to the diesel loco maintenance and crew management. All these things are dealt by the Chief Motive Power Engineer. He is assisting the principal Chief Mechanical Engineer. There is another authority known as Chief Rolling Stock Engineer. He exercises technical control over the coaching depots and also wagon depots, five depots and wagon depots. He exercises technical control. So he ensures that keeping these assets based on the requirement, based on the operations, and based on the requirement, he ensures that he enables this particular asset available always for that particular function. So, depending upon the levels of passenger and freight traffic handled by each general railway, he places these assets and he ensures the availability and reliability of the rolling stock. He manages that and he fixes the standards for these activities, and he should ensure, along with the spare parts, his Chief Rolling Stock Engineer is responsible for ensuring the spares and spare parts required for the both online as well as the preventive maintenance in a zonal railway, for the transportation needs. And then there is another authority known as CME Planning, Chief Mechanical Engineer Planning. He is a Chief Planning Engineer. He is responsible for all related to the replacement of rolling stock and requirement of rolling stock. So various plan heads, we all know, we are having the railways have the plan heads. The plan head expenditure, when investment planning takes place under the plan heads 2100, that is rolling stock program, 4100, that is machinery and plant program, and 4200 related to the works program, items, works program related to workshops and production units, that is related to structures and other important structural arrangements. So 2100, 4100, and 4200, how much has to be planned for the purpose of additions and for the purpose of additions, and also for the purpose of replacement of these assets based on the age, come based on the quota life as well as the condition of the locos or condition of the carriages, the wagon, for the contingence of these assets in the system. So principal Chief Mechanical Engineer is assisted by Chief Workshop Engineer, Chief Motive Power Engineer, Chief Rolling Stock Engineer, and Chief Planning Engineer, and all these officials assisted by PCME is associated with the finance department under the head of the financial advisor and chief accounts officer, stores and workshop, FA and CAO, SNW, stores and workshop we call them. So in some places there may be separate stores FA and CAO, and some railways there may be a workshop FA and CAO, and in some railways both may be having one HOD, having the associating the finance function. These are the functional authorities. Now, let us slowly come down to the workshop organization. In the workshop organization, who is the head of the workshop officer, workshop administration? Chief Workshop Manager. Chief Workshop Manager is the administrative head of a workshop. Zonal Railway Workshop Head is Chief Workshop. We call him Chief Workshop Manager, CWM. He is assisted by a J-grid officer known as production engineer. He is the most important person. The production engineer is responsible for drawing, planning, production control, and also providing rate fixing. That is providing some kind of allowed times for fixing the times, and then progress office and tool room, the inspection office, and direction and supervises specialized activities in shops. He does all kind of planning with reference to the rolling stock maintenance in a workshop. It is related to in a workshop. Whereas earlier we have told the authorities, they are responsible for all the workshops in a general railway. In the earlier slide, we are seeing CW, CMPE, CRSC, CME planning. These are all these HODs are responsible for all the workshop activities in a general railway. Whereas here in the workshop organization, chief workshop manager is the administrative head of the, he is a HOD and is assisted by a production engineer of a J grade rank and a personal officer. He is responsible for manpower planning and activities related to recruitment and payment of wages, recruitment of artisans for the purpose of activities in a workshop. And there is a chemist and metallurgist. He is the most important officer. They are responsible for quality control and manufacturing and other operations, because unless until a quality control is maintained for various metals, it is not possible. You will be seeing in the unless until our ferrous items, like these various items made of iron and steel, are tested in such a way there is no flaw in the metal. There is a flaw in the metal, there happens, there will be a breakdown. When there is a breakdown, breakdown is very costly in Indian railway working. In Indian railway working, a breakdown of an asset is very, very costly. It involves heavy cost. As such, we should have to have the quality checks done early to the working. As such, chemist and metallurgist is an important person. He ensures the target downturn of the workshop in a systematic way. And then comes, there are shop superintendent, that's, they are known as senior section engineers owning their shop, each shop, a smithy shop, body shop, paint shop, wheel shop, like that. Each shop in a workshop is a cost center, a center. It is known as a cost center. We can say it is a spending unit point. Each one is a cost center. Then workshop accounts officer, he may be a J grade officer, renders assistance in finance and accounting aspects of workshops. He is the most important person. And then there is a stores officer. He ensures the continuous availability of raw materials and components for the workshop activities continuously. There is a perpetual stock issues from the stock depots maintained and attached to the workshop. He ensures the continuous and perpetual stock issues to the activities to the workshop. Unless until this is ensured, we cannot achieve the targeted outer in a workshop, because for want of components, work should not be hampered in a general workshop. Normally, direct workers or various artisan staff, they are directly involved in the working. They are skilled artisans, semi-skilled artisans, highly skilled artisans, and also there may be unskilled people also there in that. So this, with this strength, chief workshop manager is the administrative head, is ensuring the the maintenance practices of a general railway workshop, which is maintained for the purpose of local maintenance, carriage maintenance, and as well as the wagon maintenance. That is how broadly the various authorities. Now coming back to our working, what is the role of a workshop accounts officer? Normally, the workshop accounts officer is directly under the control of chief workshop manager. But however, for the purpose of finance and accounting aspects, he will be reporting to the FA and CAO, stores and workshops. The responsibility of the workshop accounts officer is to see, he should give the financial advice. It means he will be clearing the various finance proposals as similar to the senior DFM in a general railway. in a division, then and various proposals will be clearing with reference to the finance aspects, and he is responsible for accounting, costing of activities, and reporting to the management for managerial intervention, corrective action. Here, the role of accounts officer is something more than the divisional accounting. In a divisional accounting, the activities are funded based on the fixed activities. As such, the funding is very easy. Here, in the case of maintenance of rolling stock, are not similar to the maintenance of assets on an open line. Here, what happens? The age come condition of the rolling stock that is coming to the workshop may be varying. As such, the incurrence of expenditure for each asset varies. Thereby, the associate accounts officer, the workshop accounts officer, he should ensure the correct account of expenditure, and as such, exercising control over expenditure of the activities also. Unless until there is a system or a mechanism for the control over expenditure by a system, of course we call it as a work order system. I will explain in detail in coming classes. So as associate accounts officer, that is workshop accounts officer, is responsible for the accounting, proper accounting and costing of activities, means cost of POH of a AC coach, cost of POH of a general second class coach, cost of POH of a AC3 tire, cost of POH of a wagon, cost of POH of a flat wagon, we call it as a flat wagon, and cost of POH of a covered wagon, cost of POH of a passenger coaching vehicle, cost of POH of a luggage van, where we call it only parcel van. So these are all the various activities costs for which we have to ensure, and the system is so important. Based on the unit cost only, the funding activities happen from the ensuring year. Again, I repeat, based on the fund costing unit cost of POH only, they form basis for the budgeting. The budget estimates for the ensuring year happens in a general workshop for maintenance practices for the ensuring year. So it is so important. But unlike in a division management, we may depend on the volume of activities and as well the inflation factor. That is, the budget can be the more incremental mode. Here it is not only incremental mode, also based on the unit cost of activity that has done in the earlier will be the basis for the formulation of funding for the ensuring budgetary estimate. That is the most important thing. And similarly, he should render assistance for material requirements along with the stores organization, because stores organization will be procuring the items under stock items, A category items, B category items, and C1 and C2 category items for their regular issue. So as an associate accounts officer, he will be rendering support to the stores organization in such a way for procurement of various materials required for the workshop. So he will be rendering assistance for the material. Similarly, he will be rendering assistance for proper manpower planning and control. Because here, if you see a zonal rail workshop, normally time office is under the control of the workshop accounts officer. Time office is under the control of the workshop accounts officer. As such, the time booking to the various activities are properly controlled, or properly rather monitored by the accounts officer, associate accounts officer. As such, it is an important aspect that manpower planning and control along with the personal department is dealt by the workshop accounts officer. Again, submission of workshop account current like other any other accounting functioning, it is a reporting matter on a government accounting mode, and also review of expenditure for the purpose of budgetary control, and also review of unit cost on a quarterly mode are dealt by the workshop accounts officer. So role of workshop accounts officer is enormous and is important, and it is the important one of the important activities assisted to chief workshop manager in a zonal railway workshop. So what are his major responsibilities? He renders financial advice. He is responsible for accounting. He is responsible for finding out the unit cost of activities. He is responsible for the providing continuous material assistance. He is responsible for the providing the manpower planning and control and ensuring that there is a proper record of manpower costs in the activities. And also he is responsible for the reporting of the various activities to the administrations in such a way for the purpose of funding, that is budgetary control, and also having the control over expenditure system, making the control over expenditure system in a particular zonal railway workshop. That is the most important role of the workshop accounts officer. Now I will deal with this. So far what I have told it is the importance of the rolling stock in Indian Railways and the expenditure related to the procurement and replacement of the workshop, as well as the maintenance practice of the workshop, that is for the online maintenance and also offline maintenance. Offline maintenance means that is nothing but preventive maintenance, which is dealt by the zonal railway workshop. And in a zonal railway workshop, various authorities related to having this function completed under the head of the principal chief mechanical engineer, that is PCME, assisted by various HODs. And the objective of a zonal railway workshop, and that means broadly what they do the work in a zonal railway workshop, and similarly the responsibility of the workshop accounts officer for rendering this service of the maintenance of rolling stock in the Indian Railway zonal railway workshops. That is so far we have dealt in the the first 8 slides. Now look at the expenditure part. How expenditure is seen in a zonal railway workshop? Normally, as an accounting, from the accounting point of view, if you see the expenditure part, then expenditure can be broadly identified as labor, material, and other expenditure. Expenditure can be identified as labor, that is manpower cost, and material, that is material component, and other expenses, other ancillary expenditure related. That is how the expenditure flow chart happens in any organization, the more so with the general workshop. Labor, normally the expenditure on labor, we collect through labor pay sheets. Here is the labor pay sheets normally we see in any entity, in any organization, even for the divisions also, divisional maintenance also, we see the labor pay sheets. Now we are all, I pass, will be passing these pay sheets. In this case, here, the expenditure part related to labor in a general workshop, normally the payments are made based on the actual attendance. I repeat again, here Indian Railways, in any other part, the wages are paid based on the assumed attendance, whereas the wages are paid based on the actual expenditure, actual attendance. Wages are paid based on the actual attendance. As such, unless until 31st is taken, only after completion of the calendar month only we can give the wages based on the actual attendance. That is how the labor laws indicate for us for the payment of wages in Indian Railway workshops. As such, we have to necessarily operate a suspense account known as a labor suspense account, so that the actual expenditure related to the labor is related to the outturn of that particular month. Normally, then we incur the actual expenditure on completion of 31st. For example, in the 31st October, you'll be in a position to pay the wages based on the actual only in the next month only, no? That is in the month of November. That is, cash outflow happens in the month of November, whereas the expenditure related to the month of October and also outturn also related to the month of October. So as such, what happens? We have to operate a labor assessments, and we will anyway, as an accounting part, we will relate the labor cost to the outturn of the shops by operating a labor suspense account. Okay, the purpose of showing this expenditure recording is to show you that the important part is the wages, payment of wages is involved in the purpose of experimenting. In the case of material, the material used in the operations, that is activities of a workshop, is two types. One is material drawn from the stock, that is stock items, which is normally the major chunk of 80 to 90% of the entire workshop material is drawn from the stock items. Only 10 to 15%, less than 10% only is directly purchased by the respective authorities. So when the material is drawn from the stores repo and the account all happens through stores monthly summaries, we call them as stores monthly summaries. Now the after the IPAS is accountable, then material draw happens through IMMS, integrated material management system, IPAS. Under IPAS we will be accounting these stores monthly JVs, and final heads is important. In the case of non-stock items, where the items are required, items are procured based on urgency, or some kind of petty items which are dealt as non-stock items, and are through non-stock again, that also we associate incurred based on the availability of the non-stock, the direct purchase budget in that respective authority. That is how the material part is accounted for. The expenditure is on account of material which is drawn from the stores, and also which is directly purchased by the respective authority, chief workshop manager. And then expenditure related to the electricity and some kind of contractual works, sanitation things, consumables, and also general maintenance of general plant machinery, and then transportation costs, various miscellaneous expenses which can be related to the activities in common, is known as other expenditure. So expenditure is broadly classified as labor, material, and other expenditure. Labor, material, and other expenditure. Under this part, some of the expenses are directly related to particular work order. Some of expenditure cannot be related to a particular work order. As such, we call them as on-cost expenditure. I will detail again in the coming chapters. And then the activity-wise costs, again we see how to arrive at the activity-wise cost in broadly. Then we will deal with the how we deal this. That is, what is the tool available? First we are talking about the activities. Next we are talking about the authorities. Then we are talking about the various expenditure part, and this expenditure part, how it is structured in terms of labor, material, and non-cost, and the activities-wise. How to arrive at the activity-wise expenditure flowchart also is. That means to collect the expenditure activity-wise, we have to have a system known as work order system. We have to have a system known as work order system. I will explain in detail in the coming classes. But anyway, for this class, we understand the activity-wise work, periodical work having one activity. Then one work order number is given. As such, the work order enables collection of expenditure element wise, that is labor, material, and on cost. Labor, the work order wise expenditure can be collected by way of material, labor, and on cost. Direct labor, direct material, on cost. On cost means indirect expenditure. Direct labor and direct material are direct expenses. So that, like that, we can structureize the expenditure related to each activity by way of a work order. So who issues this work orders? Work orders are issued by production control organization. The work orders are issued by production control organization, and these are so important. When the material is drawn against that work order, it is recorded. When the labor is labor expenditure is involved, that expenditure is recorded in the work order. When there is on cost, again the on cost expenditure is recorded in the work order. So the work order gives detail, very minute details related to the expenditure related to the activity. Again I repeat it. The expenditure related to activity in detail is recorded in a work order, that is direct labor, direct material and on cost, that is indirect expenditure related to that particular work order. So I will explain further. And then how to collect these all work orders. So we have to have a tool known as workshop general register. We generally work orders are issued by production control organization, please remember. And then workshop general register, this register is maintained in accounts office. Please remember, work orders are issued by the production control organization, whereas workshop general register, which is a financial document, of course it is a activity document maintained in a workshop accounts officer, maintained by workshop accounts officer. He is also a J grade officer. So summarized in a list known as workshop general register to enable preparation of out of the statements. So the workshop general register is maintained in accounts officer. In accounts office, it will enable us to maintain preparation of outcome statements. For that purpose, this workshop general register is maintained shop wise. Please remember, shop wise workshop general register is maintained, and as such entire workshop is also collected. So all shop summary, the work order wise details, means if a work order is there in that expenditure related English, in a smithy shop, in a bogie shop, in a wheel shop, in a paint shop, all shop expenditure, you can relate and collect the expenditure shop wise as well as the entire activity for that particular month for that outturn. That is the most important tool. A workshop, again I repeat, a workshop register, workshop general register is maintained in the accounts officer. In the accounts office, is the responsibility of the workshop accounts officer to see that WGR is posted correctly and it is prepared shop wise, and the details related to labor, material and all costs are recorded, and each shop, so we will have the expenditure detail each shop wise, thereby the respective authority, that is shop section engineer, senior section engineer of a shop, can analyze his expenditure and analyze his expenditure in detail. So that is how the workshop general list is maintained in a workshop accounts office. Then based on the workshop general register, normally we prepare statements part 1 and part 2. I will explain further in detail in the coming class, where based on which we will be clearing the expenditure, we will be recording the expenditure to the final heads based on part 1 and part 2 outcome statements. Part 2 front statement is nothing but work in progress. Part 1 means for which accounts office is responsible for clearing the expenditure from suspense account to the final heads. That means I'm using a word known as a suspense account. So here the flow of expenditure, the flow of expenditure related to labor, material, other expenditure, and the clearance of expenditure from clearance of expenditure to the final heads from these maintained in a suspense account through outcome statements, again supported by WGR, is dealt in a systematic way. That is, a suspense account is maintained. That suspense account is none other than workshop manufacturing suspense account. Okay, so expenditure incurred in a workshop is primarily booked to a suspense account known as workshop manufacturing suspense account. Okay, that is the flow of the expenditure, the flow of the activities I have just explained in detail. Now let us go, what is this suspense account? First we go to, now we are coming into the entry into the financial aspect of an account. So far we have dealt with reference to activities, and we have dealt with the related to the authorities related to the activities. Today now it is coming to the accounting part of the expenditure. So the accounting part of expenditure deals with the recording of expenses, the recording of a workshop activities, expenditure related to the workshop activities in a suspense account. Before going into that, we will just deal with what is this WMS account. So we are all aware so far, with our knowledge, we have seen demands for grants. There are Next while we are talking, now sub major heads. Today we have only demand number 84, where in the railway budget has been merged with the general budget. We call it only 84, but however our structure of demands is maintained early, like erstwhile demands, like demands 1 to 16. Previously, demand 1 and 2 relate to policy formulation and guidance. And then ordinary working expense are demands 3 to 13. Under 3 to 13, demand number 3 is general superintendent services. Demands 4, 5, 6, 7 are related to repairs and maintenance of various assets. Demands 8, 9, 10 relate to operating expenses. Demand 11 related to staff welfare. Demand 12 related to miscellaneous working expenses. Demand 13 related to discharge and pension. Demands 14 and 15 related to appropriation to funds and other suspenses. And general demand number 16 related to the capital expenditure. Under capital expenditure, we have various plannings. We are all aware, no? This is how broadly our railway structure of accounts happens. If you see the classification, we see the structure of accounts. The structure of accounts demands 1 to 16, where in which capital expenditure and revenue expenditure very nicely definedly provided under various demands. And the broad classification between capital revenue happens under capital. Again, we will see there is identification of assets under various plan heads also. So, plan heads related to a transport department like railways, we have plan heads like plan head number 11, new lines, 12, 13, like that you have various plan heads. We have plan head 2100, rolling stock management, plan head 17, computers, like that we have various plan heads. So, under these plan heads, we have three important plan heads known as plan head 7100, plan head 7200, plan head 7300. I will again repeat, plan head 7100, plan head 7200, plan head 7300, three plan heads together known as inventories in Indian languages. Now broadly, we call these plan heads are known as inventories in Indian Railways. Inventories means it is nothing but stock some kind of thing. Now I will explain what is plan head 7100. It is an account. It is a plan head stores in stock account. It is a stores in stock account. And then plan head 7200, workshop manufacturing suspense account. And 7300, miscellaneous advances capital account. So 7100, 7200, 7300, otherwise known as plan heads, also known as accounts, are suspense accounts. These three are known as suspense accounts, wherein which we, when we say suspense account, when we plan head, say plan head, immediately when we say plan head, what is coming to your mind? This plan head is supported by which source fund? So, Indian Railways, as the rules of allocation, the most important part is you have to remember the rules of allocation. Okay, the rules of allocation indicates that 7100, 7200 or 7300 are to be sourced by capital only, capital suspense only, are sourced by capital suspense. As such, 7100, 7200 and 7300, these plan heads are sourced from a source fund known as capital. So as such, workshop manufacturing suspense account is a capital suspense account. It is a what it normally defines everywhere. A definition is given. I will also read the definition. Please all of you understand and remember this. Memorize this definition. It is a process of collecting, evaluating, and analyzing and booking the expenditure for various charges for carrying out of a work or a service in a general railway workshop or in a production unit for service and manufacturing. It is a process of collecting, evaluating, analyzing and booking of expenditure of various activities for carrying out a work or a service in a workshop or a production. It means, and I say this WMS account definition, this WMS account is operated not only in general railway workshop for maintenance of rolling stock, also for the production units where the assembly and manufacturing of rolling stock takes place. There also they operate this account only. So it is a most important and prominent suspense account under plan head 7200. So when I say suspense account, when I say capital suspense account, more so it analyzes and deals so many things. It means it has a structure. So when we say it is an account, when I say it is an account having debits and credit, debits and credits, that means debit is something related to the expenditure and credit is related to the clearance of expenditure from the account. That means an account is a suspense account, which is a continuous in nature. When you operate and open a WMS account, it is a continuous account. It's a continuous in nature. That means there happens an opening balance, having the debits for the current month and the current year, and having the credits for the current month and the current year, and minus it with the credits, the closing balance remains. That means opening balance plus debits minus credits, closing balance. Opening balance plus debits minus credits is left with the closing balance. So that is how structurally workshop manufacturing suspense account operated. So workshop manufacturing suspense account had operated in general railway workshops as well as the production units to book the expenditure related to the activities pertaining to that workshop or production unit. That means the month-wise and year-wise transactions are recorded, analyzed. That means here, if you see, when I say the WMS account is a suspense account, that means it has debit, that recording of debit entries have contract credits. Similarly, a recording of credits in WMS have contract debits also. So that is how the operation of workshop manufacturing suspense account takes place. Why at all this account? So for maintaining reason, do you have to have a suspense account? So that question comes. Yes, we need to have this suspense account in detail. As such, we may not be in a position to exercise control or expenditure in detail related to the maintenance practices of the assets, related to the maintenance practice of the assets. As such, because some assets will be, age come condition of the assets will differ from year to year and time to time. As such, it is necessary that we operate this account. By way of operating this account, so what is the benefit I get? I get the cost control. I get the cost control. That means I can regulate the expenditure. I can post. What is the cost control and cost reduction? There are two items here. Please remember, a cost control, I am using the word. Cost reduction, I am using the word. The cost control is that it is dealt by the finance and accounts department controlling the expenditure based on the base admins, based on the budget grant. Okay, understand? Cost control means regulating the expenditure based on the grant, based on the grant. For example, if you don't have grant, normally we don't incur the expenditure and postpone the liability to the subsequent periods. Even if you, otherwise we have to arrest the liability. We have to arrest it. But is known as, doing that kind of exercise is known as cost control. Making, as a finance managers, finance and accounts managers, we have to do this, both cost control and as such, and also cost reduction. Cost reduction means what? Doing some kind of a research, re-engineering, value analysis, doing some kind of a activity by involving all the officials, by all the three, user department, stores department, and finance department together. We will try to achieve reduction in the expenditure in a permanent way. That means I wanted to have some kind of a component made of stainless steel only. Stainless steel is a component. But our technical advisor told us to replace this item instead of stainless steel by a fiber item, which can be, the end use can be the same. means fiber item is cheaper than the stainless steel item. As such, the reliability and the life of that particular component is similar to the stainless. As such, replacing a suitable part, that is known as cost reduction. Cost reduction can happen by way of various techniques, business re-engineering processes, then value analysis processes, value engineering processes. This can happen. So workshop manufacturing systems account enables us by way of regulating the expenditure based on ways and means, as well as by analyzing the activities through work order and work order system, and providing the cost reduction by way of re-engineering the activities and re-channelizing everything. So this is such a good account. So this accounting will help the managers, will provide the managers an insight into the expenditure. As such, cost reduction also can happen. Cost reduction can also happen. So I think all of you must have understood this, the difference between the cost reduction and cost reduction and the as well as the cost control. Okay, that is how the workshop manufacturing suspense account is important. Workshop manufacturing suspense account also provides unit cost calculations, because it closes the account monthly in a systematic way. It closes the work orders monthly and makes the WGR correctly. As such, unit cost calculations can happen, and this unit cost calculations can be compared with the previous month, as also with the other workshops of other railways also can happen through this workshop manufacturing suspense account. So this is like this important. And then comes, I will again further explain, it is debited with the total expenditure incurred on account of pay and allowances of artisan staff. Here please remember, the workshop manufacturing suspense account is debited with the labor cost of only artisans, not the office staff. Like accounts officer is there, workshop accounts office staff is not debited to WMS account. It is that in the demand number 3 only. Here only the activities, expenditure related to the activities only debited to the workshop manufacturing suspense account. That is pay and allowances of artisan staff and materials, components and raw materials drawn from stock to shop operations, and direct purchases of materials, that is purchase of materials made by the executive departments, that is respective CWM, for their activities directly, but required, urgently required for the components, and also some petty value items is also through non-stock indents, that is another thing. The carriage inwards, other charges such as electricity, water, sanitation, and other material assistance from other workshops, all those things form as a debit side of the workshop manufacturing suspense account. They form as a debit side of the workshop manufacturing suspense account. Once we operate this suspense account, because since with the tool of work order system, we'll be in a position to identify which activities having the proper dose of expenditure for that particular month for the complete work. So when I use a suspense account, it is my responsibility to clear the suspense account. As an associate accounts officer, I will be clearing the expenditure from WMS account to the final heads. How I will clear? Okay. The work order is the basis. The work order for which I have issued for the purpose of some kind of a capital works, that is works related based on the estimates. Based on the estimates for which I have funds available in the pink book, for which I have made a separate estimate for rebuilding of a loco, or a rebuilding of a carriage, a rebuilding of a wagon, or restructuring, making existing modification to the existing structure of a wagon, existing anything for that matter, which is related to capital mode expenditure. This is a capital nature of expenditure for which I have separate funds available in the pink book, against which once the work is completed against the work order, I clear the expenditure from suspense account, that is crediting the WMS account and debiting to the final heads in that particular year and clearing the WMS account. That is the first credit to the WMS account is on the completed works of the capital nature expenditure incurred in a workshop. That completed works and the expenditure related to the completed works in on capital nature of expenditure dealt in the workshop. So even you can progressively charge the clear the expenses based on the progress of the work also. Then in the case of some of the items which we have manufactured, we have manufactured and sent for stocking, means this kind of components requisition is sent by the stores officer. Normally he will place requisition on the workshop manager to he will be ordering to manufacture some 1,000 components, maybe 15,000 components or 1,000 components of springs or some kind of anything, profiles, anything for that matter, for stocking purpose, where that he will be issuing the activity during the course of his working, for the course of the activity by the journal directly. For that purpose, the funds are available in the stores stock account, and the workshop manufacturing suspense account is credited, and stores in stock account is debited after issue of materials from the workshop to the respective stores depot. So by debit to the capital suspense under stores in stock account for the stock manufactured items sent for stocking. So in that case, 7100 is debited and 7200 is credited. 7200 under workshop manufacturing suspense account is credited. Similarly, I have carried out POH works. So 100 units of POH I have carried out. So cost of POH is about 1 lakh. So 100 into 1 lakh, 1 crore is a charge to my revenue demand for repairs and maintenance of passenger coaching vehicle. Demand number 6D230, of which labor and labor on cost is primary 34, material and material on cost is primary unit 35. The revenue expenditure related to passenger coaching vehicles of a journal railway is debited, and workshop manufacturing suspense account is credited based on the completion of work of that nature. It means the outcome is completed. So once the outcome is completed, we will be clearing the expenditure from workshop manufacturing suspense account, by contra debiting to the revenue demand. Normally, this kind of expenditure related to revenue has to be cleared on a monthly basis. That is known as outturn JV, we call them. Normally, if you don't clear the item and keep them in the suspense only, what happens? Your revenue expenditure is underreported. If you underreport the revenue expenditure, your operating ratio worked out for that month is not true. The operating expenditure is not true, then it is not correct accounting. So it should lead to a good accounting practice, because at the end of the year, if you don't clear items pertaining to the completed works to the final heads and it main kept in the suspense account, will be a misclassification of expenditure. And also it will lead to defects in budgeting also. It also leads to defects in both are similar. One will trigger to other aspect. It is like that. So it is a misclassification. So we have to have responsibility to clear the expenditure to the final heads when it is related to revenue expenditure. It is the responsibility of the associate workshop accounts officer to ensure this account on a monthly basis, and more so on a yearly. At the end of the March, it is necessary that it should be dealt with. And then that is how in the case of deposit books, for the books which we carry out for other government departments, private bodies, we collect money in advance, keep it in our deposit account. When we take up the work of other government departments and private bodies, normally we collect a deposit account, deposit money, and keep the money in deposit. Based on the completion of the work, we will be debiting the deposit account and clearing the workshop manufacturing suspense account. That is how we will be clearing the expenses from this particular suspense account. And when we deal with the private bodies and other government departments, in addition to the unit cost that is dealt in the WMS account, we also levy some kind of a pro forma on cost charges, that is other administrative expenditure, which is not a charge to WMS account.
But however, we collect it. When we collect it, the respective debit goes to credit goes to JDAC Inc. and WMS account is debited to the extent of performance. To the extent of performance. So I will explain further again. So POS performance cost charges collected through WMS account will form as a Z earnings to railways, miscellaneous earnings to the railways, sundry earnings to the railways as such in a general. That is how we will be clearing. Normally, when we clear this suspense account, we have seen the debit side, we have seen the credit side, and we end up with the closing balance in a month, every month, as well as the at the end of the year also. So the closing balance, normally what are the items? Some items, work orders which are in progress, and for completed work orders for which the credit is avoided. Sometimes there may be some kind of an accountal pending due to e-recon maintenance or any such normal through e-recon, it has become more speedy. Now the transactions are complete in on a monthly basis without fail. There may be one or two items, small items for want of clarification or any such thing may be pending. So those things will be available in the closing balance. But in a subsequent month, normally we'll be clearing. This is a normal phenomenon. Then sometimes there may be unaccepted debits for the works carried out for reasons, maybe due to quality, may not be user department, may not be likely to accept the debit. There may be a dispute of item. So such kind of a thing. Then normally third item related to the closing balance is works in progress. This is nothing but unfinished goods, unfinished items in the available on the particular day of the rolling stock. And then unadjusted, sometimes there may be under recovery of the charges, on cost charges. So those items may percolate and continue in the workshop manufacturing suspense account closing balances. But however, workshop accounts officer is responsible. Workshop accounts officer is responsible to ensure that the closing balance should be only works in progress. All items are cleared to the final heads at the end of the year. It's a must seen item. It is a must review item by the accounts officer. So all items are cleared. There may be some pending items here and there for the in between the months. But at the end of the year, all items which ought to have been cleared to the final heads have to be necessarily cleared, and workshop manufacturing suspense account is cleared, and closing balance should reflect only work in progress. The closing balance should reflect only work in progress. That is broadly about the operation of workshop manufacturing suspense account. It begins with an opening balance, which is nothing but a work in progress, and debits pertaining to labor cost, material cost, and other charges, and credits pertaining to the completed works with reference to capital works that are carried out, and also revenue works that are carried out, and also other manufacturing activity that is carried out, and deposit works that is carried out, and left with only the work in progress. Please, all of you, carefully listen the progressively the how the expenditure is paid. The most important, I am just depicting how this WMS account is at a glance. I'm showing it an account which is at a glance. So balance at the debits of the manufacturing account at the commencement of the year. Then debits during the year, at the end of the year, you can see like this. Payment to labor, material in stores, material by direct purchases, and various charges. Then they become gross debits. And in between, because 7100, 7200, 7300 together known as capital suspense accounts, source of the capital. So deduct issues. If you see, there is an item known as issues to works, issues to capital stores. So deduct issues for manufacturing suspense to works with the demand. That means under these suspense accounts, under these inventories, items related to stores in stock account and a miscellaneous advance capital account, only one place only we have to necessarily fund them and also to show them for the purpose of the reviews. As such, we deduct these items from this account and we show as them as net debits. It is necessary because the net debits only deals with the related with the base and means budget. As such, we have to have the account is only, it should be reflected only one place. So in the case of works, capital, DF and OLWR, and capital stores, suspense, manufacturing stores, any returns, return stores, all these things are deduct tissues. They form as deduct tissues. And in the case of revenue, it is a credit side of the item. And to work done for other foreign revenue departments also a credit side of the item. And then gross credit, deduct tissues, as per the contract, how much is. So we have to net, project the net only in the WMS account. So anticipated balance at the close of the year, this is how we will be funding the WMS activities. An account is shown this way. This is the method of showing an account. That is how WMS account is shown. Debits, credits, opening balance plus debits minus credits is the closing balance. Closing balance is nothing but is a works in progress. As far as the workshop manufacturing suspense review is concerned, as an accounts officer, what are we doing in that? Normally, as a normal rule, that the closing balance in the workshop manufacturing suspense account are kept at 3% of the gross credits in a year. Normally, in between months, there may be some kind of some of the items which might not have been adjusted to the credits may carry forward to the next month and subsequent month they may be cleared. But however, at the end of the year, workshop manufacturing systems account should only show 3% of the gross credits. That is an ideal closing balance in the case of service-oriented workshops. In the case of manufacturing activity or production, it can go up to 3% of the gross credits in the case of revenue operations and 6% of the gross credits in the case of manufacturing work studies, production units or some kind of those things. So it is important that first review is the percentage review of the closing balance for the gross credits. It is 3% in the case of revenue operations and 6% in the case of manufacturing operations. So what are the points to be seen in the case of these items? If we go further detail, we have to see whether the materials and stores are drawn. In case the higher the closing balance, what is to be seen? Materials and stores are drawn disproportionately as compared to the normal requirements. Since the materials are in the stock depot, simply they cannot dump the material to the shop floor as they may be used in the subsequent, like that it should not happen. Then with the progress of manufacturing of pairs for stocking, so stock account has to be sent, material has to be sent to the stores depot. It has not been taken for want of funds under that budget. So you have to see that once the activity is completed, the material is sent to the stocking purpose, and accordingly the accountant should take place and should not result in the accumulation in the WMS account. They should not be accumulated in WMS account. Normally, is there any closure of, by reviewing so, is there any delay in closing of work orders for administrative reasons, for one reason or other reason? Physically, work may be done, but work orders are not closed for various reasons, for want of debits, for want of some kind of a thing, for want of other details. So those things have to be seen. Then in the case of revision of hourly rates, if you don't revise the average hourly rates for charging the labor cost, because normally labor cost is charged to the operations based on the number of hours spent by each worker collected through the timesheets. So if the average hourly rates are not updated, when you pay the DA, and if you don't update the average rates, if you don't charge up to the final heads, then it will become in the closing balance. That means expenditure ought to have been booked to the final heads has not been booked and remained in the capital suspense account, which is not an agreeable thing. It is nothing but a misclassification of expenditure between capital and revenue, which is a very serious issue. Then whether proper deposit is available for taking up the works. In the case of agreement, some deposit work has been taken. Deposit work is assessed as 1 crore. But actual expenditure has become 1 crore 20 lakhs. So 20 lakhs is excess expenditure. So that remains in the closing balance. So we must collect the money very quickly, very early. Before incurring the expenditure itself, we have to collect the money from the depositors. So like that, unaccepted debits and charges by the foreign railways. And
by those things are also be seen under review of WMS account. For example, if the review is dealt by at a higher level, at a manager level, board level, or the FN source level, general level, normally they look at the, that is the review by earlier two things are review by accounts officers, review of WMS 1/2 and two, these two slides are review by the accounts officer. When you write in the examination, you should review of the accounts officer points. Then a manager review means at a board level. Then in that case, by reviewing this, they see capacity utilization workshops, deployment of skilled labor and their utilization manufacturing operations, close watch of materials, shop floor during change in the activities and their consumption pattern. Normally diesel locomotive, you know, the components related diesel locomotive should come down because we are withdrawing the diesel locos gradually from the system. Like that, quantum of on cost, how much quantum of on cost is happening to the activities? Is our indirect expenditure more than the direct expenditure in production units and as well as general railway workshop? These things have to be seen in the managerial reviews by the railway board and higher ups as such, and general railway management administration under GM's office. So normally I have given some targets and actual expenditure. What happens if you analyze the outer coaches, bridges, glued joints, weld joints, or various WMS counts I have given? This is only for the means if they don't achieve the target in terms of physical units, thereby your indirect expenditure is more. That means you are not utilizing the capacity to the fullest extent. That is happens. If you see the same account under 20, 70-12, 70-14, 70-17, 70-15, under various activities in a journal railway, this is only an example. So closing balance in crores, if you see in this slide, in some places it is 12%, in some places it is 2%. So here, why this is happening? Means there will be in some places there is a minus balance. This cannot happen. These minus balance, these are all reflecting the inefficiencies in the activities and accountable of the material part, or accountable of the labor part, or accountable of the inward debit part. Thereby, this WMS account analysis gives us the true picture, the financial picture of that particular workshop. For example, if you see, in the case of flashbed welding plant, there is a 15% closing balance. There is a 15% closing balance. It means your closing balance is higher, that means your issues are not happening, or maybe your closing balance indicating the non-clearance of items from the WMS account on account of accountable or as well as the physical also. So as a manager, in the case of wagon workshop, wagons under 27-12, out of these, the closing balance is again 61%. That means 18.80 crores in WMS account is accumulating. That means the debits ought to have been booked to the final heads under revenue demand has been continued in the closing balance in the suspense account, which is a serious irregularity. So these things can be analyzed by way of this account. It's only an example. So I'm only telling that this account enables us the managerial control as well as the activity, at least the financial control with reference to activities, and providing basis inputs for the corrective action by the authorities, that respective managers and mechanical managers who are the user department using expenditure. So expenditure ought to have been booked to demand number 6. Expenditure ought to have been booked to demand number 7. Expenditure ought to have booked to various revisions and workshops are the part of the review by the accounts officer, based on which the work orders have to be broadly reviewed in such a way that they find out the corrective action required to be taken by the associate managers involved in clearing the suspense account. That is the important. Again, through this, also this WMS account also provides cost comparison of activities, that is comparing the activities pertaining to previous period to this period, how the unit cost is rising. Since the unit cost is rising, how the again have to be funded under the various budgetary reviews. So as such, we have to be knowing the the impact of expenditure under this account. Similarly, there is some kind of revised accounting model, revised costing models also can be deployed to contain the expenditure, to contain the revenue expenditure by way of rescheduling the items. That means expenditure towards labor, material, and under this basic cost element, how much, variable cost element, how much, cost of high value items, how much. In the case of the means, the POH scheduling, if you want to have a reason, rationalization, that is must change items, change the items based on the income conditions, change the items of the capital space. For example, if you take an AC coach, then in the roof mount air condition is a capital space that has life, and also coach has life. So both have to be correlated in such a way, both get terminated, that both their quarter lives are at a time the asset should be used. There should not be any new component, new capital space in your old coach. So as such, we will be containing the cost of items revaluing the items by way of must change items, items which are income conditions, items which are capital spares. By doing a recasting these things, we can cost comparison and cost control activities can happen through workshop manufacturing suspense account through various authorities. Friends, I will be dealing with the, I have given some of the MCQs workshop accounts. So I request you all, three slides I showing here, how to deal these, can we deal? Or you please, any one of you have any doubts, please respond.
The participants, any queries, please raise the hand.
What I mean to say, these MCQs I gave for today's these things, please practice these MCQs. Please practice these MCQs after reading the session.
Sir, please check one or two queries in the chat box, sir.
Chat box, yeah, I'll check.
Now, what is contra entry? One query.
If it is lectured in Hindi or mixed, and OWR is abolished, yes. OWR is abolished, that means revenue only. I agree. OWR is abolished. Hindi in between. What is a contra entry means? The contra entry means indicating there is a contra entry. For example, by clearing the suspense account, we have a contra debit. Contra debit and clearing the contra entry to WMS account. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Audible, sir. Yeah.
There is a question known as contra entry. Contra entry means contra debit or a contra credit by clearing this suspense account. That is what I mean in this.
Any queries, please raise your hand. Please submit feedback on the session also.
Sir, Raghura, sir, if possible, please share this PPT in the Zoom chat, sir. Otherwise,
okay,
please share it to me.
Okay.
Otherwise, please share it to me. I'll share in the WhatsApp groups.
Okay.
You can share in the chat box, sir.
Okay.
In the chat box.
To manage, sir.
Before that, please close the PPT in the desktop, sir.
Okay, okay. I'll close the PPT in the desktop. Okay. Okay. Any questions, please? Any more questions?
I will unmute all of the participants.
Please ask them.
All are unmuted. You can ask your questions.
The abbreviation of NTXR is neutral train examiner. He's a neutral train examiner for the purpose of quality control, for the purpose of quality control of the BOH work. There is a question known as NTXR, that is neutral train examiner. Normally, once the work is completed in a workshop, there is a neutral train examiner. He will be certifying the work related to the BOH. Certificate. Unless and until neutral train examiner is certified, there is no that is related to the quality check, related to the safety.
Hello, sir. Hello.
Hello, Bali sir.
Sir, please explain about the source monthly summary.
Source monthly summary means every month on completion of the material of har mahine source report se issue hota hai material for various activities. Maybe workshop hota hai, journal revision hota hai, or anybody for that matter. We have draws the material. Each consignee se mutabi the material is drawn to workshops for activities, for a POH, for a corrosion repair, for a special repair, for manufacturing, for division. Aisa har mahine pura mila ke ek mahine ke pura transactions ek activity ke liye stores monthly summary se mutabik diya jata hai. A financial transaction hota hai, har work order ko pura mahine ke liye ek entry hota hai by clearing the stores and start account and by debiting the workshop manufacturing suspense account, by debiting the manufacturing suspense account, by crediting the stores in stock account, is how that. That is the important thing. G.
Mr. Ajay Singh, please unmute. Ajay Singh.
Sir, namaste.
Ajay Singh ji, batao.
Sir, ये WMS को clear कैसे करते हैं? Workshop manufacturing suspense को clear कैसे करते हैं?
हर वर्कशॉप अकाउंट ऑफिस में हर महीने वर्कशॉप जनरल रजिस्टर आउटर स्टेटमेंट बनाने के बाद ये क्लियर करना है. रिस्पांसिबिलिटी का वर्कशॉप अकाउंट ऑफिस का रिस्पांसिबिलिटी होता है हर महीने वर्कशॉप मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सस्पेंस अकाउंट क्लियर करके फाइनल हेड को देना पड़ता है. मे बी रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर, मे बी एक्सपेंडिचर रिलेटेड टू द अदर वर्क्स, मे बी डिविजन्स, मे बी अदर रेलवेज, ऐसा क्लियर करना पड़ेगा. हर महीने पूरा WHR के बेसिस से कंप्लीटेड वर्क के मुताबिक एक्सपेंडिचर WMS अकाउंट से क्लियर करना चाहिए.
गुड आफ्टरनून सर. वी आर ऑल नो दैट WMS इज ए कैपिटल सस्पेंस सेट ऑफ अकाउंट्स under demand number 16.
Yes.
But what is the relation of revenue expenditure in this case?
What expenditure?
Revenue expenditure involved in the WMS?
The expenditure ought to be cleared to the revenue operations, which is booked to capital suspense, had to be cleared. Aisa clear karna chahiye.
Yes, sir.
पहले अंडर जोनल रेलवे वर्कशॉप में एक्सपेंडिचर पहले WMS को बुक करना चाहिए, बुक करना पड़ेगा. वहां से फाइनल हेड्स को क्लियर करना है वर्क ऑर्डर से मुताबिक.
विश्वनाथ प्लीज अनम्यूट.
यस सर, थैंक यू.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, Vishwanath, please tell, please ask your query.
Sir, my question was, the WMS is a capital sufficient set of accounts under demand number 16. What is the revenue expenditure related, any related with WMS account?
The revenue expenditure in a journal revenue workshop, when the maintenance, POH maintenance of expenditure is pehle workshop manufacturing suspense account to book karna chahiye. ये yes. है ग्रॉस ग्रॉस बेस एक्सपेंडिचर है हर महीने
okay.
इससे निकाल के वर्कशॉप मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सस्पेंस से निकाल के फाइनल हेड को बुक करना पड़ेगा ऑन कंप्लीटेड वर्क्स के लिए कंप्लीट वर्क्स के लिए पीओएच वर्क कंप्लीट हुआ इससे मुताबिक कितना यूनिट हो गया इससे मुताबिक डिमांड नंबर 16 को डेबिट करके डब्ल्यूएमएस को क्रेडिट करना पड़ेगा ठीक है
ओके सर ओके सर
ये जरूर करना पड़ेगा हर महीने अनलेस टिल यू क्लियर द एक्सपेंडिचर रेवेन्यू से कैपिटल सस्पेंस से हमारा रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर पूरा नहीं है इफ यू डोंट क्लियर हमारा ऑपरेटिंग रेशियो गलत होता है ये महीने का ऑपरेटिंग रेशियो करेक्ट दिखाने के लिए वो जरूर निकालना पड़ेगा ठीक है
इट इज मैंडेटरी
It is mandatory.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Sir, no more queries from the participants, sir. Yeah? Can you end
okay. it?
Yeah. Thank you. Behalf of Sitara, I thank faculty, Sri P. Raghuragaru from Education faculty yeah? For elaborating session on this workshop accounts. This is the part one of the workshop account series. Another three sessions are going to be planned in the next week and coming weeks. Yeah. To remind you once again, tomorrow the login time is 2:45 p.m. The session from 3 to 4:30 p.m. And the topic is profit costing. Faculty is the M. Indraya, Senior Lecturer, RE. Thank you, once again. And all.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.